Did you wish when you started out with All in the Family that you could make it more biting the way the British version supposedly is? All of British television is different from American television, but they do the most outrageous racial slurs and things in British comedy. Yeah. And they yawk at it like we used to in eighth grade and all.
Well, no, I didn't want to do it because there are many things different about the way the British handle television and entertainment generally. For example, Till Death Do Us Part, which was that show in England.
I shouldn't have said the English version of this, because that's a show similar to this.
They're really quite different, but that was the starting point, no doubt. And but they did, I think, 22 shows, and they were on 3.5 years. Mm-hmm. We've been on 1.5 years and have done 37.
There's the
difference in America's appetite for it. We just have to keep going every week another show, and I don't think that much vitriol every week, nor am I interested in it really. I think people are much more complicated than all hate or all love, or you know, we've all got a little bit of a lot of things.
Mm-hmm. Have you run into I'll put this more. I was going to say, have you run into a bigot who really associates with Archie? A friend of mine has. He's a newsstand dealer who, this friend of mine once was working for McCarthy, and so they were used to wear the button, and he and the newsstand dealer used to go at each other in a semi-good-natured way. Right. But the guy always says, hey, Archie really gave it to you guys last night, you know, and all. So he gets a certain pleasure and maybe a release of pressure. From Archie's presence.
Sure. I imagine there are...
Well, you could view it as reinforcing his prejudices, too, I suppose.
Well, I think this is America. It's a free country. If a guy wants to make a hero out of Archie, thank heavens he has a fool to use as his hero. Mm-hmm. I mean, Archie's a foolish man. And why shouldn't the guy who wants a fool for a hero have his fool?
They always talk about the healing value of satire. Can anybody think of an example in history where satire actually healed something?
Well, I think someone told me about this period in, perhaps it was the 30s, when the fear of the hood gangs and the gang warfare in Chicago was so great, and that element wore these zoot suits. Recall the style, the zoot suit, and it had a certain amount of fear just attached to that fashion, and I think there was a Mexican comedian whose name I cannot repeat now, who did an act and wore a zoot suit, and he satirized this whole image and reduced it to laughter, and in this way healed the fear. And in that way, help the situation.
Yeah.
I think laughter has a way of doing that. If people expect too much. They expect of, and I keep thinking of what a fool I would be, or all of us working on a show would be, if we thought that after the Judeo-Christian ethic, which has had some 2,000 years to rid the human heart or soul of prejudice, has done as well as it's done, what on earth do people expect of a half-hour situation comedy? And wouldn't we'd be foolish if we thought we can do better than that whole ethic. So we're not about... We don't think we're going to change the world. We just hope we'll make a little... We'll matter a little.
Do you and Carol O'Connor ever fight?
Sure.
I'd like to hear about that when we come back.
All right.
We'll be right back.